Welcome, friend. In the next lecture of several variable calculus, in the previous lecture we discussed the chain rule 1, that is the chain rule case 1, and we solved some examples on this chain rule 1 case. Now in today's session we have to discuss the chain rule case 2 and general version for the chain rule. So we start to write the chain rule case 2. Okay, so what we see, it is in the chain rule first case. What we see here, z is function of two variable, that is x and y, and these x and y are the function of one variable, and we draw a tree diagram. And how we find this dabba z by or we can say dz by dt, we take a product of the partial derivatives along the paths and we add them. So what is the partial derivative here? Dabba z by dabba x, here dx by dt, here dabba z by dabba y, and here dy by dt. This, and now just the product of this dabba z by dabba x into dx by dt plus dabba z by dabba y dy by dt. This is our chain rule. That means here what we take, z is function of two variable, and these two variables are the function of this function of one variable. Now here it changes, z is again now in the case second, we have to take z is function of two variable, and these two variables are again a function of two variables. That means we have to write the chain rule. So how we write? Let z is equal to f of xy is a differentiable function, of variable x and y, where x is equal to g of st and y is equal to h of st are differentiable functions of two variables. Which two variables? S and t. These are again a functions of two variables, s and t. Okay, then what we can see, that then z is a composite function of two variables, s and t, and what we can write here, dabba z by dabba what s is equal to. Now z is again a function of two variable, therefore dabba z by z is function of what variable x and y, dabba x by dabba s, plus z is again a function of y, that is dabba z by dabba y, and this y is again a function of s, so dabba y by dabba s. And what we can write also, one more equation, that is dabba z by dabba t, it is equal to dabba z by dabba x into dabba x by what, dabba s we have to replace by t. Now here again dabba z by dabba y into dabba y by dabba t. So this is the chain rule case 2. Okay, so would we write a one note, we write note. So what we have, first note, in the chain rule case 2, there are different variables, There are different variables. Suppose z is variable, x, y are variable, and s and t are also variables. So in first, that is where, what we write where x are s and t are independent variables. They are called as independent variables. Then there are other variables, that is x and y are called called intermediate variable. Intermediate variables. Okay. And z is what? Z is a which variable z? Dependent variable. Dependent variables. Z is dependent, x and y are intermediate, and s and t are independent variable. Now for remembering this chain rule, we draw a tree diagram. To remember chain rule, case second, we draw, what we have to draw? Tree diagram. Okay, that is, by using tree diagram we can remember this chain rule very easily. So how we draw this? We have a z variable. This z variable is a function. This z is variable is a function of what? This is function of x and y, and this x and y is again a function of what? S and t. Again z is function of y, and this y is again a function of s and t. And we write a partial derivatives on these branches. These are called as the branches for the tree. And we write the derivatives dy by z by dy by x dy by x by dy by s dy by x by dy by t dy by z by dy by y dy by z by dy by y by dy by s dy by y by dy by t. And how we find now? To find dy by z by dy by s. So what we have to find? Dy by z by dy by s. How we find this? We have to take product of the partial derivatives along each path from z to s. So z to s, how much path? This z goes to x goes to s, and what? The z goes to y goes to s. That is, we have to take product of these partial derivatives, and we have to add this. We get a chain rule first expression. Okay, so to find dy by z by dy by x, take a product of each partial derivatives along each path from what? Z to S. How much path will be there? Two paths. So two products will be there, and add them. And then what we have to do? Add them. So what we are getting? Dy by z by dy by s is equal to, so first part z x s. So first is dy by z by dy by x into dy by x by daba s, and along second path now daba z by daba y, and we have to go to the s, so daba y by daba s. Similarly we can find, what we have to find, we can find daba z by daba t. How we find this? Again you have to take a product of the partial derivatives along the each path from z to t. So there are two paths, take a product of them and add this together. So you are getting the answer like this. Okay, now we have to use this chain rule to differentiate the some composite function. We will go for the some problems. We will take one problem on chain rule case. Second, we have given z is equal to e raised to x sine y, x is equal to st square, and y is equal to s square t. What we can see here, where we see that z is function of what? Xy. And z is equal to z of xy is function of x and y, and x is equal to what? G of st, and y is equal to h of st are functions of s and t. Hence we use which chain rule case second. Okay, because z is function of two variable, and these two variables are again a function of two variable, that is s and t. Okay, so what we have? Again you can draw the tree diagram. Z is function of what? X and y, and this x and y again a function of s and t. Again this can be function of s and t. You can write daba z by daba s, daba x, daba x by daba s, daba x by daba t, daba z by daba y, daba z by daba s, or daba y by daba t. Now just take a product of the path from z to s, each paths, and add them for daba z by daba what? First we find daba z by daba t or s. It is equal to what? First path is z x s, so daba z by daba x into daba x by daba s, plus second path is z y s, so daba z by daba y into daba y by daba s. Now just find the derivatives, you will get the answer. Daba z by daba x, so derivative of z with respect to x, keeping y constant. Derivative of e raised to x is e raised to x, sine y is constant. Now daba x by daba s, it is derivative of x, s is, it should be 1, therefore it is what? This remaining daba z by daba y, again it derivative of sine y is cos y, e raised to x cos y into what? Daba y by daba s, s 2t, 2st. Okay, 2st. So just put the values, or you can put the value of x and y also here. So it should be t square e raised to x, x value is e raised to s t square sine y, plus here 2st e raised to x, value of x is st square. Here also you can put the value of y. Value of y is what? S square t. And here also x value x. Then into what? Into cos y. Value of y is s square t. This is our first daba z by daba first partial derivative. Now we can find the second partial derivative, daba z by daba t. It is equal to first part z x t. So daba z by daba x into daba x by daba t plus daba z by daba y into what? Daba y by daba t. Now again find out the derivative, daba z by daba x. Daba z by daba x, again you have to find similarly. Here e raised to x sin y into daba x by daba t. Now this derivative of this with respect to t, that is 2st. Is it? And on what? Daba z by daba y, it should be what? Sin y derivative cos y e raised to x. Sin derivative is cos y into daba y by daba t. It should be what? S square. Now put the value of x, y and you write it is in proper way. That is 2st e raised to value of x st square sin s square t plus what? S square e raised to st square cos of s square t. And this is our daba z by daba t. Now if you have given s and t value, you can put this and you will get the value, partial derivative at that point. So in the similar way we can solve so many problems. Now we write the general version for the chain rule. Chain rule, and we have to take now general version. Okay, so we write a statement, let u is equal, u is a differentiable function. Differentiable function of n variables x1, x2 and so on, xn, and this xi are functions of m variables t1, t2 and so on, tm, then u is differentiable function of t1, t2 and so on, tm, and we can write the expressions. What? Daba u bar daba ti. Here is I. It is equal to what? It is equal to daba u by daba x1, daba x1 by daba ti. Plus, then u is function of what? X2. This x2 is again a function of ti. And in this way, we can write daba u by daba xn. And this xn is a function of, again, ti, for I is equal to 1, 2, m. That means we rewrite this is a general version. If you take I is equal to 1, then you get first expression. I is equal to 2, second expression. I is equal to 3, 4, 5. How much expressions you are getting? M expressions. For general version or for a chain rule, In case 2, there are 2 variables, therefore 2 expressions. Then, here we can take this x1 to xn are functions of m variables, therefore m expressions will be here. Okay. Now, we solve one problem on a chain rule general version. So, we have given, write out the chain rule for the case w is equal to f of x, y, z, t and x is equal to x of u, v, y is equal to y of u, v, z is equal to z of u, v and t is equal to t of u, v. That means what? This w is a function of 4 variable and this 4 variable x, y, z, t are a function of 2 variable. That means in the general version we have given that is n is equal to what? 4 and there m is equal to what? 2. And we have to write the chain rule for this. So how we write this? We have to take a help of tree diagram. So first we write, we have given that, what we have given that w is equal to f of x, y, z, t is a function of 4 variable, 4 variables x, y, z and t, and what? And these four variables x, y, z and t are functions of 2 variables a, u and v. Then what we can write? Then w is a differentiable function of u and v, and we write a chain rule using tree diagram. So we have to draw tree diagram. So what is our mean? That is w. This w is function of what? W is function of 4 variable, that is which variable? X, y, z and t. And this x, y, z, t are function of u and v. This is again function of u, v. This is again function of u, v. This is again function of u, v. Now we have to write the partial derivatives dabba w by dabba x. Here dabba x by dabba what? U. Dabba x by dabba v. Similarly you can write for all this. So now what we have to write? We have to write dabba w by dabba what? Dabba w by dabba u. It is equal to. Now how much path from w to path from? Path from w to what? W to u. How much path is? First path w, x and u. Second path is what? W, y and u. Third path is w, z and u. Is it? Next fourth path is w, t and u. So you have to take product of the partial derivatives along all these fourth path and we have to add this. So first is what? Dabba w by dabba what? X into dabba x by dabba u along first part. Second part dabba w by dabba y into dabba y by dabba u plus third part w to u, wz u. So dabba w by dabba z by dabba u plus dabba w by dabba t by dabba u. Similarly, we can write dabba w by dabba v. How we write? Dabba w by dabba x into dabba x by dabba
v.
Again dou bar w bar dou bar y dou bar y bar dou bar v plus dou bar w bar dou bar z dou bar z bar dou bar v plus dou bar w bar dou bar t into dou bar t by dou bar what v. In the similar way you can write or you can solve so many problems on a chain rule general question. So we will take next few examples in the next lecture. Thank you very much.